Buccaneers. Come aboard, me hearties. It's 4:30 and time for all good seamen to come and join Pete the Pirate for a half hour of fun and entertainment. We'll be joined by Papa, Bugs Bunny, and Sly, Sneaky, Sylvester Cat. So, heave-ho, and away we go.
The Fairwind lies at anchor a half league east of the Leeward Islands. Off the larboard beam, the Flying Fox is hove to under the guns of Pete the Pirate's ship. For Pete has captured the Flying Fox and rescued Betty Belmont from Bad Bill Bradley.
Ahoy, Buccaneers, and welcome aboard the Fairwind for today. I tell ye, it took us about that long to take care of Bad Bill Bradley, eh? You remember how easily we overcame him without firing a shot. And let me tell you more about it. Let me get down here on the quarterdeck, and I'll tell you just how we're going to save this Betty Belmont. Now, here's what had happened. Bad Bill Bradley kidnapped a lady named Betty Belmont, a girl, actually. She's the daughter of Lord and Lady Belmont, and they lived on the island of Antago. Well, as you know, he hove to yesterday under our guns, and we went ashore, or rather went aboard his ship. And I tell you, Buccaneers, he never made a whimper, did exactly as I saw it, told him. And we now have him in irons, and his entire crew. I have 10 men from my ship aboard his. Calico Jack is leading that skeleton crew, and I'm going to have Calico Jack take the Flying Fox back to Antago to return Betty Belmont to her parents. Then I'm going to have him go right back on to Pirate Islands and put the Flying Fox in the guard fleet that surrounds Pirate Islands. Aye. And I tell you, the next time I go back to Pirate Islands, I'll pick up Jack and the men I've sent back with him. Didn't take us long to take care of that black-hearted rogue, did it? I tell you, no. Now, because of just such things as this, we need as fine a crew as we can muster, you and I. So let's be having a look to see who sails with Pete the Pirate on today's crew. Hide down there by the capstan, strike up a chanty. Here they are, pinned right here to the mast.
In Amsterdam there lived a maid, mark well what I do say. In Amsterdam there lived a maid, and she was mistress of her trade. I'll go no more a roving with you, fair maid. A roving, since roving's been my ruin. I'll go no more a roving with you, fair maid. Her eyes is like the stars so bright, mark well what I do say. Her eyes is like the stars so bright, her face is fair, her step is light. I'll go no more a roving with you.
Tis as fine a lot of seafaring folk as we've had aboard in a while, eh? I tell you, they're a fine lot now. I told you the Flying Fox was bound for Pirate Islands. And Calico Jack should have that ship just about ready to sail. I want to get Betty Belmont back to her parents as quickly as I can. Tell you what, let's see if we can make Jack hear us. He's not very far away there. Ahoy, Jack!
Aye, Captain.
There you are. Pretty efficient fellow, Jack. Are you about ready to make sail?
The men are at the capstan, sir, and ready to make sail.
I tell you, he's a good man. If it weren't for a long time, I'd have him as first mate, I would. Have you enough men aboard to handle her?
Aye, Captain. These men will take her through anything she can sail through.
It wouldn't be a very big storm by the look of the size of her. Well, make haste, then. You've a long way to go. And I want you to get Betty Belmont back to her parents safely.
With luck, we'll have her ashore in Antago by midday tomorrow.
All right, Jack. Goodbye.
Goodbye, Captain. I'll see you back at Pirate Islands.
I'll be there.
All right, now, Lance.
I tell you, he's a good man, Buccaneers, and I'm glad that Neptune talked me into going after the Flying Fox and making him return that little girl. I tell you, he's a black-hearted rogue, he is. And I'm glad we got him all straightened out. Oh, I meant to tell you, I forgot all about telling you about this. Just have no sense. This is chest. That's the only bit of booty that Black Bill had aboard his ship. And I thought he might as well be relieved of it. But I didn't get a key, and I've had a little bit of trouble opening it. Let me see if I've got a knife here somewhere that I can maybe work on this lock a little bit with. I'm sure this is full of treasure. Now, let me... Let's pry it loose.
Pizza dummy!
Now, Neptune, I'm surprised at you. I'd like to know why you say a thing like that. Didn't I rescue Betty Belmont and send her back to her parents just like you asked? Wasn't that what you wanted me to do all along?
Yeah. I don't mean that. That's not why you're a dummy.
Well, then why am I a dummy? Not why am I a dummy. I mean, why are you calling me a dummy, huh?
Because you think there's treasure in that chest.
Well, why shouldn't there be treasure in this chest? It's a treasure. It looks like a treasure chest. It's heavy. Of course there's treasure in this chest. It's plenty.
Yes, but how could Bad Bill Bradley get treasure? Him sailing that little ketch. What's not much bigger than a longboat? Anybody could tell that he didn't have enough booty aboard that ship to buy a square meal, let alone...
You belay your squawking. Now, yeah, I'm trying to work on this. You're bothering me. I'm trying to get this chest open here.
No use opening it. There's not going to be anything in it.
I told you to be quiet. Now, I don't want another single word out of you. Now, you're just bothering me, and I can't get this chest open the way I think it should.
Pizza dummy.
I heard you. And I'm telling you that I don't want any more. I don't want you to say any more. I've warned you for the last time. You're going to get in real trouble if you keep talking that way now.
All right. No need to get mad about it.
Yeah. I need something heavier than this knife here. There. That's a bigger knife, huh? Now, let me see here. I don't know what the best way to do it. If I just had the key, I wouldn't have any problems, but I... let me see if I can start working on this edge with this big knife.
No need trying to open that chest. It's...
Now, I tell you, I'm going to pull every one of your tail feathers out if you don't be quiet. I don't want any more out of you at all. Not another word.
All right. I'm just trying to help.
Yeah, trying to help. A fat lot of help you are. You haven't done me any good at all.
Why don't you shoot the lock with a pistol?
Why don't you keep your trap shut? Shoot the lock with a pistol. That's the silly. Well, because I never thought of it. That's a pretty good idea. Yeah.
Hold your ears!
All right. Everybody holding their ears? Let's see. I get this about this way, I guess. Now, let's see if we can knock that off there, huh? There. Now, any luck at all, we'll have that.
There's nothing in the chest! There's nothing in the chest!
Well, now, you just be quiet. There is, too, something in the chest. The only reason that I looked a little disappointed was there wasn't quite as much in there as I thought there was going to be. But there's plenty in the chest. And you've just talked, and I don't want another single word out of you. Now, you just pay close attention to what I'm saying. An old book, an old piece of paper. A few coins. There aren't many coins, I'll show you. Not a handful in the whole. A lot of it. Hey, Neptune. Yeah, I probably made him mad. Well, that's too bad, but that's the way it has to be. If he's mad, he's just mad. I'm sorry. Let me gather these up. Here. I tell you, when it comes to finding booty, buccaneers, I probably am the unluckiest pirate who ever sailed the seas. Now, there you are, not enough in there to buy much more than a square meal for crew for a day. Well, that's all right. Not gonna do me any good. Hey, what's this? How about this book, eh? It's in German. Well, see what I've got here. Hey, buccaneers. Tis a treasure chart of some sort or another. Yeah. I can't make it. Oh, wait, here's Martinique. By heaven, a treasure chart. Aye, this may be worth more than if that chest had been filled with gold, eh? By Jove, I don't know, though. Martinique. Yeah. Sunken treasure, eh? Buccaneers,
Pete!
I told you not to talk to me. Now you be quiet. I don't know where he went. Hey, Neptune, where'd you go there a minute ago? Huh? What? Oh, blast it all. It's all right now. You can talk now. It's all right. I give you permission to talk because I want to know where you went. Where'd you go?
Down to the Orlop deck.
The Orlop deck. What'd you get down there for? Nothing down there but powder and shot.
There's something else.
Something else? What? What else is down there?
Fred's cage.
Oh, yeah. I forgot about that for a minute. Now let's see where we go here. I don't know. It's a few days' sail from here. Well, buccaneers, I suppose we could try it. Yeah, I forgot all about Fred's cage down there, Neptune. I didn't think of that.
Pete?
What do you want now, huh?
Fred's getting out of his cage.
What? What did you say? Fred's... Oh, Fred's not getting out of his... he's always playing tricks like that on me, see? Always telling me something's happened when it isn't happening at all.
Pete, no, I'm not. He really is getting out.
Now you listen here. You're just doing altogether too much talking. I don't want you playing any more tricks on me. I know I've been a little harsh with you today. I know that. But I don't want you playing any more tricks on me. I know that Fred wouldn't get out of that cage, and I want you to just be quiet.
Well, I warned him.
Well, Neptune, I tell you, I've got a little friend of mine here, and I want you to keep your mouth shut there for a minute, will you? And Stripe? This is Stripey Stripe, Buccaneers, and you know what he tells you about, don't you? You ready to tell him today, Stripe? Well, tell him. Oh, he's too shy again, and he wants me to tell you that when you see the red stripes, you know you're getting the best germ killer in any toothpaste. It kills almost all the bad breath and tooth decay germs. And what's more, Stripe looks and tastes so good that you'll just naturally want to brush better and more often, as the dentist says you should. Now, Stripey, you have a song about that, haven't you? Well, why don't you sing it? Are you going to dance or are you going to sing? Some days, he's a dancer. See, he doesn't really dance very well, but he thinks he can. Stripey, don't dance. Don't, please, don't dance.
Fun, feet I both uncleans like crazy, creep, cry, crazy. Keeps your mouth as fresh as a daisy. S-T-R-I-P-E, Stripe. Tastes good, too.
I fucking hear you run along, Stripe, huh? You remember what Stripey has to say about Stripe toothpaste, and the next time you go to the store, you look for the good-tasting red and white toothpaste in a carton that looks just like that. And it's called Stripe. I tell you, you'll find it mighty fine-tasting.